There's a lot of people that's got criticism or joking about my lungs giving up. Yes, guys, I fought septicemia the last week, but it's fine. You can have fun at my expense, who cares? Anyway, we're back on the beach. We're not all healthy yet, but we're still pushing through. We Generation X. We'll make it work. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We had a beautiful sunrise and we missed it. Sorry guys. But we are here. For that, Frankie Two Socks and myself. Some plugs gone unstuck. Somewhere in the Mfolosium Sunduzi system. Is daar pront par dit? Dit ruik pure bees, pa. Pure bees. I've got some content for you guys. We can do, don't know how accurate it's going to be, but we're doing fishing predictions. And weather predictions, can't call it weather forecast, that's illegal. And we're using artificial intelligence. Otherwise, there was no time. That I wouldn't have the time to do it because of my language barrier. But look at that beautiful sunrise. Who cares about language and grammar when you can walk on the beach every day, experiencing that beauty? Bardet is just happy that we got up this morning. Hey, as jy bly, kom jong, moenie so lui wees nie. Ja. Moderately southerly wind. At the moment tide was nice and high again. So we're gonna, this white water tells us that the gullies is closed up and that we're gonna have a strong side wash from south to north. That is from there all the way to there. I think we're very close to high tide because it's still pushing up. Oh, it's at the roundabout turn. It's about 10 past 5 this point at the moment. Tomorrow shad season opens up. Yes, and the water temperatures has risen. Contrary to popular belief that our ocean is getting warmer, we only find a change in currents. We found a very long cold winter that started late, and this morning it's a two jacket morning here at St. Lucia Beach. So yeah, global warming, climate change, I'm not so sure. I just think it's the universe in the perfect cycle, and some scientists refuse to take ancient knowledge, wisdom into calculation of the GIS office driven science. Biggest bullshit of the century. What we can tell you about this beaches at the moment is that it's building. It is depositing a lot of ocean borne sediment. And here we can see from the flushing river that it is from south to north. That's no myth anymore. I quite like the new software update. I just wish the manufacturer would talk to professional photographers when they make a software update, because there's some things that they changed that didn't need to be changed, and now I missed it, but I'll get used to it. Oh, look at my hair. Let's talk about the sea turtle nest. It's still there. I don't know if it's intact anymore, but it's still there. Let's have a look. The theory is that when a nest gets washed over by the ocean, it doesn't hatch. That we've proven to be bullshit. And now with all the rain, we know that the eggs are now nice and wet. They're drenched. we can see it in the sand. The eggs are drenched. And I'm confident if they weren't lifted, I'm confident that we will have a hatching here on the midnight of the 13th, the morning of the 14th of January 2024. Okay, even with the southeasterly blowing, there's no brown water exiting the lake system at the moment. It means that we've got marine water retention, but the water levels up in the estuary towards Narrows is very, very, very shallow. That said, let's go and have a look what is happening at the mouth. Right, we've got a new lady doing the narration for us on all the things that needs to be said on the channel. We used to have Leah Munsami. We had to let her go. Yes, guys, artificial intelligence does become labor intensive and too expensive. I thought she's a pommy, but no. She corrected me. She's an Australian chick. So she's Sheila. Hear what the AI people has got to say about the fishing conditions here on St. Lucia Beach for Friday, Saturday and Sunday. We've got some footage that we can use it on. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful sunrise. Beautiful gully. What a beautiful morning.
Here is the weather and fishing predictions for Friday the 1st of December, Saturday the 2nd of December, and Sunday the 3rd of December 2023 for Rock and Surf Fishing St. Lucia Estuary Isom Angeliso Wetlands Park. Friday the 1st of December. Weather: partly cloudy with a high of 27 degrees Celsius. Wind: northwest 15 to 25 knots becoming southwest 25 to 35 knots in the afternoon. Tides: morning high tide, 7:19 a.m. Afternoon high tide, 7:28 p.m. Fishing: fishing will be best in the morning as the wind will be picking up in the afternoon. The best spots to fish will be at the northern beaches, estuary right opposite Boardwalk, Ingwe, Jabula and Main Beach. Remember, shad season is open again from the 1st of December 2023. Minimum size is 300 mm, bag limit is 4. Saturday the 2nd of December. Weather: sunny with a high of 28 degrees Celsius. Wind: southwest 25 to 35 knots decreasing to southwest 15 to 25 knots in the afternoon. Tides: morning high tide, 6:59 a.m. Afternoon high tide, 6:07 p.m. Fishing: fishing will be good in the morning and afternoon. The best spots to fish will be at the northern beaches, Jabula and Main Beach due to the predominant south winds on Friday evening. Sidewash is expected to be quite strong from south to north. Sunday the 3rd of December 2023. Weather: sunny with a high of 29 degrees Celsius. Wind: southwest 10 to 15 knots becoming variable 5 to 10 knots in the afternoon. Tides: morning high tide, 6:39 a.m. Afternoon high tide, 5:45 p.m. Fishing: fishing will be good in the morning and afternoon. The best spots to fish will be at the northern beaches, Jabula and Main Beach. Remember to obtain a valid fishing permit. St. Lucia Estuary Post Office will be open Friday whole day and Saturday until 1300 if you forgot to get yours. Please note that these are just predictions and the actual weather and fishing conditions may vary.
Sorry guys, Sheila's pronunciation of the South African words is not all out there, but she's the best we can afford at this moment, so enjoy her narration.
Global marine life is on the move due to rising sea temperatures. This is causing a number of problems, both for the environment and for the economy. As the water gets warmer, tropical species are moving towards the poles. This is disrupting ecosystems and causing problems for temperate species, which are having to move away or adapt. The changes in marine life are also having an impact on the economy, as some industries are being affected by the changes in fish distribution. The reasons for this movement are complex. One of the main factors is that warmer water is more hospitable to tropical species. This means that they can survive and reproduce more easily in these areas. Additionally, warmer water can also lead to changes in ocean currents, which can help tropical species to spread to new areas. The ecological consequences of this movement are also significant. Changes in species diversity can have a ripple effect throughout the ecosystem. For example, if a predator species is unable to move away from warming waters, it may prey on other species that are not adapted to the new conditions. This can lead to population declines and even extinctions. The economic impacts of this movement are also significant. Some industries, such as fishing, are being affected by the changes in fish distribution. For example, as cod stocks have moved further north, the fishing industry in the Atlantic Ocean has had to adapt. The movement of global marine life is a complex issue with far-reaching consequences. It is important to understand the reasons for this movement and the impacts that it is having in order to develop effective mitigation strategies.
They never fail to amaze me, these fucking alcoholics. Hey? Never fail to amaze me. We've arrived here at the estuary mouth. Water colors is beautiful. The ocean water is running in all around the Sandbank Peninsula. We're going to make the walk this morning to show you that leaving nature to take its course is not always the right thing to do, especially where there's human interference that happened over the last 400 years. Right, it happened! I always took it upon myself, if I am giving out the knowledge, the prophecy, that this is going to happen, but I was playing with other people's calves. They don't want to step up to the public eye and into the public open space to say that this is going to happen, because they don't like the criticism and the hubris, childishness of the public that doesn't know anything. So the sand is washing into the estuary. Yes, it's happening. I haven't been here for 4 weeks to give a chance to settle completely, so that there's no denial from anybody that it's happening. Let's just zoom in a little. Right, I can't do it from the director's view. I have to be outside the director's view to zoom in. Look at all that sediment that washed into the west. This is a fuck up. Look in the relation to where I'm standing, where the Umsunduzi Umfolozi beach channel is. I'm not going to call it a river because it is a man-made beach channel. Right, and that's all the sediment that washed into the west of the channel. And that is our tree stump. And look how much sediment's on the other side of our tree stump. I used to use the tree stump as a leading photo. I don't know if you guys can remember, or leading to the shot. Just look at all the sediment. This is literally, I don't want to say it's just hundreds of thousands of cubic meters of sand, because I'm thinking we're reaching the word millions in our count here. Anyway, I don't want to sound like Jacob Zuma that can't count, so I'm not going to claim how much sand has moved in here. I just know it's a fucking lot. And this is going to damage the estuary permanently. And the sediment, the windblown sediment from the north coming towards the south, is just as bad. But let nature take its course. Yeah, there's a lot of biblical scholars that will say God is great and Jesus is good and all that, and I believe in that. But believe me, I run the channel on a daily prayer. Don't think that I'm an atheist or blasphemy. All I'm saying is you can't go and pray and sit at the table tonight and pray and Jesus will deliver steak to your door or to your table. If you don't show up, it won't happen. We've been given dominion over nature, and that comes with responsibilities. And if you're too useless to take the responsibility to fix this, stay out of the way of the people that want to. There's a lot of intelligent people. I'm not one of them. There's a lot of intelligent people that wants to fix that, that knows how to fix it, and they're running out of time. Just pan across the estuary and see how it pivoted with the southerly winds back to the north, and now it's making for long flat beaches again, difficult and dangerous swimming conditions, and difficult and dangerous launching conditions. And Uncle Frank is taking out his frustration on an innocent bystander. But anyway, that is the mouth that pivoted to the north. The sunrise against the Mapelan Dune is just absolutely fantastic this morning. And I think I've got something
The Cape St. Lucia sand dune, also known as Maybellaine Bay, stands as a natural marvel with a rich history of formation. The dune's origins trace back thousands of years to the complex interplay of wind, sand, and coastal dynamics. It formed through the accumulation of wind-blown sand along the shoreline, gradually building up over time. The prevailing winds, predominantly from the southeast, played a key role in shaping this expansive dune system. Height. The Cape St. Lucia sand dune is renowned for its impressive height, with some sections reaching heights of over 180 meters, 590 feet above sea level. This elevation makes it one of the highest vegetated sand dunes in the world. The dynamic equilibrium between sand deposition and erosion contributes to its ever-changing height and contours. Vegetation adaptations. What makes this dune particularly fascinating is the tenacity of vegetation that manages to thrive in this challenging environment. Certain plant species, adapted to the harsh conditions of shifting sands and strong winds, contribute to stabilizing the dune. Their presence adds to the ecological diversity of the area. Ecological significance. The dune plays a crucial role in the broader ecosystem of Maybellaine Bay. It serves as a natural barrier, protecting inland areas from storm surges and providing a habitat for various plant and animal species. The dune system is an integral part of the delicate balance that characterizes coastal ecosystems.
Floating nicely there in the Estuary Mountain. I came up a lot north. I hope I'm at the right spot. I had to pick up the tripod there. Had a wash over from a wave. Beautiful, beautiful morning here at St. Lucia Estuary this morning. And Five Star is coming up slowly into the channel, making sure everybody is sitting properly. Meter bucket with two 100 four stroke Yamahas on the back. Yes, I chose the line right here. Gonna have a nice shot of Barrett exiting the mud break. Chosen to run a little bit north of those ones standing up on his shoulder, but it's not going to last long. It's closing up in front of him. He has to turn east, southeast. He's turned east, and that's a launch. Happy hunting, guys. Oh, look at those beautiful waves. Enjoy the day. And we've got some tannin running out, so the marine retention has drained out once again in the Philosium Sandusi channel and out of the St. Lucia Estuary, and the sediment buildup is absolutely scary. The face of the world economy collapsing. We didn't need this bad news. We could have take preventative measures and create a viable ecosystem. But I'm so tired of being the only voice telling people how important a working and functional estuarine system is. Anyway, we have to go back. Our job is done here for today. Now we're back, and Pardet is still as excited as ever. Play catch, catch, go! Well, that's fetched. Not catch, it's fetch. But she doesn't play fetch well. She likes to play seek and destroy. Now that we know how important the Mopelon Bay dune is, do you guys realize how much damage the GEF 5 has done to remove this dune that was built with second-hand dredger spoils? Yo! It's going on low tide, and we still can't fish the southern beaches toward the Estuary mouth. Only that one gully, but that water is now full of tannin. There won't be any marine species there. So we have to walk far north past Ingwen Jabula and Main Beach before we'll only be able to start fishing maybe at Main Beach. Vantage Cruiser going there, Hippo and Croc Tour. Beautiful day today. If you want to, you can make bookings. Somebody hit the WhatsApp button.
It's been a while since I've been this far down towards Iguala Guala. It's a cacophony of ear candy.
Catholic Church here at the end of Mackenzie Street.
Oh, it's beautiful down at the bottom here. This is St. Lucia Wilds. We need to get a photo here so we can drop them into the Facebook marketing. Det and myself decided we're not going to walk Iguala Guala today. We're not in the mood. Every time I stop, she lies down, so she must also be getting old, just like me. Strangler's Fix in St. Lucia is always amazing. It's a huge tree that this one circumvented. Now it's towering on top, above the other trees.